To get up. Thank you for the invitation. I'm coming from the Venice area, so I bring the beach shores with me. I wrote this first piece based on a YouTube that I saw of Wynonna LaDuc, and she says, they say, she always references to where she got her information from. So that's where I wrote this piece from. Scattered around the world, dreaming in circles, the people of the seventh fire yearn a setting sunbelt strategy. They water the future of the earth with the gravity it takes to inhale one's first breath. They even posit a code red, as neglecting agency and colonizing dependency is literally a naturalized citizen certificate away. Aquila's heel is abundance, and as we peruse it, it pursues others' wealth. It even infringes on others' health. No, it's not redundant greenery, because I don't own a Save the Planet tea. Because recycling is our idea of replenishing, not the Earth's choice of cleansing. Hmm. So walking these streets, we hold fear nearer than the physics of subsistence. I often wonder, if we've derailed, detached, and displaced, how will we ever find our place? But there's always ceremony and poetry, they say. As a storyteller rhymes behind borders, bars bear the glory of a Sunday morning. Before the gallo betrays the night, homie selling out his sons for the carbon copyrights to infamy. That's, of course, until the cops roll by. Then I'm reminded, yes, it is we are still the dust and once. So I don't pray that you stay. I pray that you find your way. I pray I remain. A synchronized destiny has written you in for cage, rhyming time and space. I pray poetry, proses of choices. I pray I remain. Initiating in justice and in peace, by and in the streets, because the restlessness of grief doesn't let us sleep. The troubled waters, the shadow, the slaughter, the fodder of change and progress every morning to scream to our face. You are no less. You are no less, and you are no less. So reign over me, new city gleam. Let me dress in this new so-called personality, one that shreds greed and shits envy. And me, this non-apologetic me that cuts in front of me along grocery lines. Because of course, their time is more precious than mine. How could I not feel so right? As nostalgic tragedies haunt the carolly, I know it's when you face it that you have the rest of your life to test porch histories. Anomalities of well-rounded families astounded by name-calling. Nosotros. Ellos dijeron que éramos qué. So you whitewash your N-word, game up your racist sword, double-bladed and sworn, too legit to quit, too soon to forget. We regret to inform you. If we scorned you, we warned you. There are boundaries, you say. So before you choke me, I grab you by the throat like Robert Frost quotes. Because words outweigh motives. And baby, I receive your legacy in chapter stories, each titled Infinite Glory. The air warms of the hasteful embrace. The smell will linger and taste long after the day, Maria would say. Your pores sweat the regrets of all that you say yes. Your words have meanings. And sadly, others have to live with them. If you're an a-hole, how can you expect anybody to stay? My way or the highway, you say, Father, there has to be a better end. Because the solution lies in the problem, they say. That's what they say. Out of love, light, land, and bread, out of compassion. Out of compassion comes a need to envision less meaning to genocide and more of an end. To punitive government heads as mausoleums cry, corporal carceral stench business draws fines, claim minds, difficult with distraction, the path of the spirit. Can you hear them say? What would it mean to fight to win? To stop planning, suffering, theorizing our debts? What would it mean to live? A litany of continuous rebirth that storytellers keep alive, the talk to accompany the walk of respecting only one law, natural law. That's what LaDuc says, they say, that's what they say, the highest law. So I deal with men more than I deal with women. I don't idealize them, I betray all that they should be for what they are. Listening to Mark G's words as I deal with my boys, these walking contradictions men are. So if you see a thug cry, share a feeling, or tell the story of a scar, no, you've witnessed healing in the hardest of them all. Because I ain't a hater. I just know when Faco got sold to the highest bidder. A straight gallery, one-hit quitter, falling in the flames of fame, and what others say. In the original, West Coast criminals rage over art and where others say they say. That's what they say. Cool. That's what. West